अन्योन्यमासीत् सञ्जल्प उत्तमश्लोकचेतसाम् कौरवेन्द्रपुरस्त्रीणां सर्वश्रुतिमनोहरः. दिस श्लोक वाज स्पोकन अबाउट द लेडीज ऑफ हस्तिनापुर. सो द लेडीज ऑफ हस्तिनापुर वेंट ऑन द रूफ टॉप्स एंड स्टार्टेड कॉन्वर्सिंग अबाउट कृष्णा वेन कृष्णा वॉज डिपार्टिंग फ्रॉम हस्तिनापुर. एक्चुअली कृष्णा केम फ्रॉम द्वारका टू हस्तिनापुर टू असिस्ट द पांडवास ड्यूरिंग द कुरुक्षेत्र वॉर. And even after the war was complete, Krishna stayed in Hastinapur to pacify the Pandavas and solace them and to pacify his sister Subhadra, because during the war Subhadra's son Abhimanyu died. So Krishna wanted to comfort her and encourage her, and Krishna also wanted to give guidance to the Pandavas and Yudhishthir Maharaj specifically to rule the kingdom. So like that, for several reasons, Krishna stayed back at Hastinapur even after Kurukshetra war. Now at one point Krishna felt that I must go to Dwaraka back, and he took permission from Yudhishthir Maharaj. And Yudhishthir, with a heavy heart, he gave permission to Krishna. Okay Krishna, now you can go, we miss you, we feel separation from you, still it's necessary that you need to go to Dwaraka to give your association and company to the Dwarakavasis also. So when Yudhishthir said like this, Krishna started for his journey to Dwaraka. At that time several devotees at Hastinapur assembled at one place to give a farewell to Krishna. So many people gathered with musical instruments and garlands and chanting of Swasti Vachan or auspicious mantras just to honor Krishna as he was going on a journey. So Pandavas came and embraced Krishna, and Pandavas were feeling separation from Krishna, and Kunti Maharani also came to see of Krishna. So like that, people were engaged in just seeing of Krishna. At that time the ladies of Hastinapur, who cannot come on the street to see of Krishna, they all went to the rooftops, and from the rooftops they were observing Krishna. So how Krishna is going from Hastinapur, all these ladies were observing from the rooftops. So there they started conversing about Krishna. All of these ladies loved Krishna so much. Although they are simple household ladies, still they have great knowledge about the Supreme Lord Krishna. So they must have heard from some bona fide brahmanas and devotees, and they have developed a great knowledge about Krishna. With that knowledge, mixed with so much of love and affection for Krishna, they started conversing about Krishna. That's what this shloka says. Anyonyam asit sanjalpa uttama shloka chetasam. Anyonyam asit sanjalpa. Sanjalpa means a very light conversation. So these ladies started discussing about Krishna amongst themselves. Uttama shloka chetasam. Their chetasa, their mind is completely absorbed in loving devotion for Krishna. Kauravendrapurastrinam, all these threes, all these ladies are the ladies of Kauravendrapura. Kauravendrapura is basically Hastinapur. Okay, Hastinapur is ruled by the Kuru dynasty. So Kauravendrapura means Hastinapur. So all these threes of Kauravendrapura, they started discussing about Krishna with love. And what is the nature of their conversation? Sarva Shruti Manoharaha. Because they are all discussing about Krishna, their words, their conversations are very attractive to the ears of everybody. Sarva Shruti Manoharaha. Shruti means ears. Mana means mind or heart. Sarva Shruti Manoharaha means they are extremely pleasing to everybody's mind and everybody's ears also, because they are about Krishna. And another important meaning of this line is Sarva Shruti Manoharaha. There are a category of scriptures called Shruti scriptures. Shruti scriptures means those scriptures that are understood or learned through hearing. So in the previous days, people do not have books to study. Scripture is not a book. So scripture is in the form of sound. A guru speaks the scripture and the disciples listen to that scriptures, and then he will just retain the full knowledge. So shrutis are those scriptures which are learned by hearing. So these shruti scriptures are known to glorify various qualities of Krishna, the majesty and opulence of Krishna. But the ladies, when they are discussing about Krishna with so much love, their talks are more attractive than Shruti's also. Sarva Shruti Manoharaha. Because Shruti's describe the opulence, majesty and grandeur of the Lord. Shruti scriptures describe the majestic aspect or the greatness of the Lord. But these ladies are discussing Krishna's activities and pastimes or qualities with so much of love and affection. Because ultimately, all the scriptures are meant to take us to a point of loving God, loving Krishna. So scriptures are glorifying Krishna's grandeur, but these devotees, these ladies of Hastinapur, they are glorifying Krishna's sweetness with so much love and affection. So these loving words are more attractive than these reverential words. So scriptures or Shruti scriptures are glorifying Krishna with so much of respect, awe and reverence. But these people are glorifying Krishna with so much love and affection. So thus, these ladies' talks are considered more beautiful than even Shruti scriptures. So when someone loves Krishna, and with that love, when someone speaks about Krishna, that fills the hearts of those people who are hearing them. They are more attractive than even Shruti scriptures also, according to this shloka of Srimad Bhagavatam. That is the meaning of this shloka, Hare Krishna.
For more such devotional programs, please watch Hare Krishna television. To get this channel, please contact your cable or DTH operator. For more information, please call 8767-845-845.